This segment of the lesson deals with the life of Mukesh, yet another child whose spring of childhood is lost in the dingy cells of bangle making industry. Mukesh lives with his family of his father, grandparents, brother and his wife. The bangle maker's income is so meager and they are exploited by the overlords and many others. Their suffering and stigma of their caste is seen as their karam or destiny. So, none dare to dream. But Mukesh wants to drive a car and chooses to become a motor mechanic. Let's know Firozabad. Firozabad is a small industrial town not too far away from Saheb's Simapuri. It is known as the world's largest glass blowing industry, and the colorful bangles made there are a part of rich Indian tradition. This industry has been thriving for more than 200 years. There is a prevalent child labor and manpower exploitation in Firozabad. Bangle making is a family-run business, and families do the welding of the spirals of glass. The workers' payment is so sparsely. Children are preferred as laborers in these industries as their labor charge is much less than the elders. The workers face severe problems due to the silica dust while making, polishing and welding the bangles. They suffer from various medical problems such as lung infections, burns, allergies and poor vision. Some of them lose their eyesight in their late adulthood. Before we could read the lesson, let's take a sneak peek into the lives of bangle makers of Firozabad.
वर्किंग स्टार्ट हो जाती है। भट्टी में जब कांच मेल्ट हो जाता है तो उसको हम लोग लोहे की लबियों से, बड़ी बड़ी लबियाँ होती हैं, उससे हम लोग निकालते हैं। बेलन पे जाती है, उसके बाद उसमें चूड़ी बन जाती है, चूड़ी स्प्रिंग टाइप की चूड़ी बन जाती है। कुछ जरी का काम करते हैं, कुछ हिल का काम करते हैं, कुछ पॉलिश का काम करते हैं, कुछ लोग ऐसे ही प्लेन भी बेचते हैं, जुड़ने के बाद प्लेन चूड़ी भी बिकती है।
I want to drive a car. Mukesh insists on being his own master. I'll be a motor mechanic, he announces. Do you know anything about cars? I ask. I will learn to drive a car, he answers, looking straight into my eyes. His dream looms like a mirage amidst the dust of streets that fill his town, Firozabad, famous for its bangles. Every other family in Firozabad is engaged in making bangles. It is the center of India's glass-blowing industry, where families have spent generations working around furnaces, welding glass, making bangles for all the women in the land, it seems. Mukesh's family is among them. None of them know that it is illegal for children like him to work in the glass furnaces with high temperatures, in dingy cells, without air and light. That the law, if enforced, could get him and all those 20,000 children out of the hot furnaces where they slog their daylight hours, often losing the brightness of their eyes. Mukesh's eyes beam as he volunteers to take me home, which he proudly says is being rebuilt. We walk down stinking lanes choked with garbage, past homes that remain hovels with crumbling walls, wobbly doors, no windows, crowded with families of humans and animals coexisting in a primeval state. He stops at the door of one such house, bangs a wobbly iron door with his foot, and pushes it down. We enter a half-built shack. In one part of it, thatched with dead grass, is a firewood stove over which sits a large vessel of sizzling spinach leaves. On the ground, in large aluminium platters, are more chopped vegetables. A frail young woman is cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through the eyes filled with smoke, she smiles. She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother. Not much older in years, she has begun to command respect as a Bahu, the daughter-in-law of the house, already in charge of three men, her husband, Mukesh, and their father. When the older man enters, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall and brings her veil closer to her face. As custom demands, daughters-in-law must veil their faces before male elders. In this case, the elder is an impoverished bangle maker, despite long years of hard labor, first as a tailor, then a bangle maker, he has failed to renovate a house, send his two sons to school. All he managed to do is teach them what he knows, the art of making bangles. It is his karam, his destiny, says Mukesh's grandmother, who has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from polishing the glass of bangles. Can a God-given lineage ever be broken? She implies. Born in the caste of bangle makers, they have seen nothing but bangles. In the house, in the yard, in every other house, every other yard, every street in Firozabad, spirals of bangles, sunny gold, paddy green, royal blue, pink, purple, every color born out of the seven colors of the rainbow, lie in mounds in unkempt yards or piled on four-wheeled hand carts pushed by young men along the narrow lanes of the shanty town. And in dark hutments, next to lines of flames of flickering oil lamps, sit boys and girls with their fathers and mothers, welding pieces of colored glass into circles of bangles. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. That is why they often end up losing their eyesight before they become adults. Savita, a young girl in a drab pink dress, sits alongside an elderly woman, soldering pieces of glass. As her hands move mechanically like the tongs of a machine, I wonder if she knows the sanctity of the bangles she helps make. It symbolizes an urban woman's suhag, auspiciousness in marriage. It will dawn on her suddenly one day when her head is draped with a red veil, her hands dyed with red henna, and red bangles rolled into her wrists. She will then become a bride, like the old woman beside her who became one many years ago. She still has bangles on her wrist, but no light in her eyes.
Ek vakt ser bhar khana bhi nahi khaya, she says, in a voice drained of joy. She has not enjoyed even one full meal in her entire lifetime. That's what she has reaped. Her husband, an old man with a flowing beard, says, I know nothing except bangles. All I have done is make a house for the family to live in. Hearing him, one wonders if he has achieved what many have failed in their lifetime. He has a roof over his head. The cry of not having money to do anything except to carry on the business of making bangles, not even enough to eat, rings in every home. The young men echo the lament of their elders. Little has moved with time, it seems, in Firozabad. Years of mind-numbing toil have killed all initiative and the ability to dream. Why not organize yourselves into a cooperative? I ask a group of young men who have fallen into the vicious circle of middlemen, who trapped their fathers and forefathers. Even if we get organized, we are the ones who will be hauled up by the police, beaten and dragged to jail for doing something illegal, they say. There is no leader among them, no one who could help them see things differently. Their fathers are as tired as they are. They talk endlessly in a spiral that moves from poverty to apathy to greed to injustice. Listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. One of the family caught in a web of poverty, burdened by the stigma of caste in which they are born. The other, a vicious circle of the sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats, and the politicians. Together, they have imposed the baggage on the child that he cannot put down. Before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father. To do anything else would mean to dare, and daring is not a part of his growing up. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I am cheered. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. He will go to a garage and learn, but the garage is a long way from his home. I will walk, he insists. Do you also dream of flying a plane? He is suddenly silent. No, he says, staring at the ground. In a small murmur, there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. He is content to dream of cars that he sees hurtling down the streets of his town. Few airplanes fly over Firozabad. Let's recapitulate. Mukesh is the central character who is born into the family of bangle makers. The bangle makers are born, live and die poor. They are subjected to severe exploitation by being paid low. They live in poor conditions all their life. Their caste remains a stigma. According to a study, only 40% of the children get to go to school and the rest get employed in the bangle industries. For a meager sum, the bangle makers would never be able to organize themselves in cooperatives, fearing the powerful boss men. The colorful bangles they make don't bring any color in their life. Both Saheb and Mukesh are poor, exploited, and don't have access to education. Saheb has migrated from another land while Mukesh's family stays in Firozabad generations together. Saheb's family have picked up the profession rag picking by compulsion as a means of survival, whereas Mukesh's family is involved in bangle making for generations together. They are subjugated and made to suffer in poverty. Saheb pawns down his freedom to work in a tea shop while Mukesh dares to dream to be a mechanic someday. Both hold on to hope and positivism.